G'day, I hope you're all doing great, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy to tell you that it's been 8 days since my tragic accident, and in this particular vlog or episode, I'm gonna show you how I spent more than 9 hours at St. Luke's emergency room. So stay tuned. On May 2nd, on the day of the accident, at past 1 p.m., I arrived at St. Luke's BGC with the help of a taxi driver. So as you can see, I'm inside an emergency room and I'm waiting to be treated by the nurses at this top-tier hospital. At this point, as you can see, I'm seated on this wheelchair. I have bruises on my legs, and I realized that my left elbow was fractured or broken, and the billing department of the hospital was checking on my HMO card. Initially, there was a misunderstanding as I've given them my old health card, but this was immediately addressed as I told them to locate my MaxiCare account using my TIN ID. My
left elbow is probably dislocated. I could not move it. I feel so much pain whenever I try to move it. So I cannot even move my finger. And I've been here for like more than 10 minutes already inside this nurse station. But all in all, I've been here for like 20 minutes already. They had to check my ID. By the way, this is St. Luke's, the gig, and ID and everything I had to sign, some kind of waiver, etc. So I don't know what I'm waiting for. I don't know what I'm waiting for, but the doctor said that I will be given pain reliever or killer and then antihistamine for the bruises that I got from what happened today. So I literally begged for a painkiller because I could no longer bear the pain. My God. And I'm so thirsty as well at the same time. Alright, so I think the reason why I'm waiting here is that they're trying to verify my health card. There was a mixture of cards. I've given them my old card. For my new card, I've never used it, so I'm not really sure which HMO I'm covered for. So I gave them my IntelliCare, the old one. It should have been MaxiCare because that's what my company is paying for. So, alright, so I don't have the card, so I've just given them an ID for them to locate my account. I don't even know if it's MaxiCare or IntelliCare, but I just told him, so if it's my company, then it's MaxiCare.
So after 3 hours of waiting or ordeal, an orthopedic doctor finally came in to fix my broken elbow, and that was followed by a series of x-rays. I mean, a lot and lot of x-rays.
I'm done with the x-ray. They did x-ray technically all of my body, so it's like more than 10 shots, x-ray shots, or I don't know what you call that, but and I'm done with tetanus, so 2 shots as well for tetanus, anti-tetanus. It didn't hurt at all, but the fact that you're getting like 2 shots on both elbows, and this is what became of my shoulder and elbow, really. I'm feeling a bit dizzy already, so. Thank you. description. Look at that, that's so dirty. So, and me and my broken elbow. Well, that's life. Here's an update. I arrived at the hospital at 1:30 p.m. It's already 3:25, so it's like two hours already. And according to the attending nurse, I'm just waiting for the result of x-rays. And the x-ray actually took like 10 to 20 minutes. That's how long the x-ray process was. You know, they took the x-ray to all of my body, literally. And especially this dislocated left elbow, shoulder. And the problem is I had difficulty moving this part, especially my finger, during the x-ray process. According to the nurse, it's gonna take like 1 to 2 hours for me to wait for it to get the result. And I don't know if I'm gonna get confined, but the x-ray results will definitely determine whether, you know, what's gonna happen next. I'll be endorsed to an orthopedic doctor probably, but I just hope that it's just dislocation, because if there are other damages or internal injuries that the x-ray will find, then I might be confined for a couple of days, and I don't like that to happen. Alright, so I don't know. So I was moved to this room while waiting for the x-ray. A doctor came and he fixed the dislocated elbow, because I don't know, it wasn't in a good form. Talagang na dislocate talaga. And now I feel a lot better. I can move it. Unlike earlier, it was not in its normal form. But this time I can move it. But you know, the way he fixed it, it was, I felt excruciating pain, you know, total pain, absolute pain. So, but that's just a momentary, or just fleeting pain. It was like torture, but this time I feel better. I can move my elbow, I can move my finger, and I'm not feeling seething pain already. So we're just waiting for the result of the x-ray. What's gonna happen next, I don't know. Just, you know, hoping that there are no internal injuries so far. That's what I'm hoping for. And yeah. They simply had to fix the dislocation, and I can go home now. After this, I was advised to call MaxiCare, because I'll just be waiting for the x-ray results, and they need to x-ray my elbow again. So there's gonna be another round of x-ray after this, and I'm not feeling any dizziness at all. It's just that the dislocated elbow is just really, really painful. So far, you know, I'm just okay. I'm just really thankful that this is, you know, this is the only injury that I got. So what happened is, I did not tell you yet what happened. So I was on my scooter on the way down from up in the hill. And suddenly, I don't know, I bumped into something. And all I can remember is that I was on the pavement. You know, I was on, nasa daan na lang ako. It's, what I'm thankful for is that in Divisoria Street, there were no other, you know, pedestrians or motorists that particular moment. Walang car, because, you know, I couldn't imagine what would have happened if I did figure in an accident on that particular spot, you know, down the road of McKinley Hill. And there were like, may mga umaandar po sa sakyan, so it could have been worse, but, you know, lesson learned. You know, the pain, really, seething pain, that's all I can feel. But now I feel better. Now that the elbow has been fixed to its normal form, and I can go home, which is what I'm happy about. So this is the x-ray area of St. Luke's. Another round of x-ray, so I'm just hoping that walang internal bleeding. So there you go, parang evacuee sa tsura ko. Ang dumi ng paa, lahat, so dumi. Yan yung half shoes ko. I was through with the second x-ray. And after that, another doctor advised I'm gonna undergo CT scan because they found something sa neck area ko. And they're gonna include my head as well for the CT scan. I don't know, but you know, if it's gonna turn out good, no internal bleeding or injuries, then I can go home. That's what I'm hoping for. Well, looks like it's progressing. I'm waiting for the CT scan of my neck and head, and according to them, they found something wrong in the neck area. That's the reason why I have to pay for this. It's not covered by my MaxiCare, really. And yeah, I had to pay like 3,000 to 4,000 for this. This is my third x-ray. It's gonna be mobile this time. I don't know why I'm gonna undergo another x-ray for the third time. So they're bringing the x-ray machine to me. Earlier, I had to go to the x-ray room at St. Luke's. So, by the way, this is the emergency room. And that's the x-ray machine that they're gonna be using. So they're simply confirming why the doctor requested another x-ray, because he had to fix my elbow again for the second time, and it was really, really painful. He said it's going back to the deformed, you know, status of the bones, but I don't know. But he was able to fix it again, I hope so, and then requested for another x-ray. Alright, so I'm done with the CT scan. Looks like that's the last step. You know, remember, I came here at past 1 this afternoon, and it's already 6:07 p.m. So most of, you know, the more than 5 hour ordeal was devoted to fixing this and multiple x-rays. So there were like 3 rounds of x-rays given to me, and the last one was a CT scan for possible head and neck injury. So I hope I will be sent home or discharged after this. I'm just waiting for the result of the CT scan. Wish me luck. So I'm going home, so it's already past almost 9 actually. So I've been here at past 1, so it's like 9 hours of having all these checkups and x-rays. What else? The last one was CT scan, and I had to wait for like 3 hours for the results because they thought that there's something in my neck, you know, there's something wrong with my head or my neck. So, you know, I had to spend like thousands for the CT scan. It turned out that there's nothing wrong, but you know, we trust them because they're the experts. So yeah, I was at the ER waiting for the next steps. Am I gonna get surgically operated, etc.? So I don't know, but so far I'm going home. Alright, so here I am, all alone. I don't have any relatives at all. This is pandemic, as you can see. I don't know, I don't pity myself really. Well, we need to be independent, and I've been very independent ever since. So I'm outside. This is a building, and I'm waiting for my Grab car to pick me up.